Hello everyone. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make this really beautiful textured, very warm and cozy cable stitch baby sleep sack. So the yarn that I'm using is Bernat Sport yarn, and I'm going to be using a 7mm hook. And the size of this, I would say it's pretty, I want to call it a one size, because it will be very long on a newborn, like a brand new baby, I'm sure. But the nice thing I liked about the sleep sack when I made it for my baby, I wish I actually knew about this for all of my babies. But anyway, I made it like a typical, like a little baby blanket. So he actually was able to use it right from being a brand new baby, and he was comfy in it right up until about a year. So you could make it a little wider and a little longer if you're making it for an older baby than a year, but I would say anywhere from newborn to a year old, and this will be a nice cozy sleep sack for the colder months. So let's go ahead and get started. We are going to chain 40. So to make your starting chain, you're going to wrap the yarn around your finger and just cross it over gently. Pick up this bottom piece and push a little bit of that top piece of yarn through and pull it to make a loop. If I move a little too quickly on any stitches, check out these stitch tutorials in my channel, because you'll be able to get some stitch tutorials where I focus completely on one particular stitch, okay? So I will try and go slow enough for those of you that are new to crochet, or maybe you're learning this stitch for the first time, this cable stitch. Let's go ahead and get started. So we are going to chain 40. You're going to yarn over your hook and pull through the loop. Yarn over your hook, pull through the loop. Yarn over your hook and pull through the loop. That's how we make our chain. So we're just going to go ahead until we reach 40 chains and then come back. Okay, so now that you've made your chain 40, we're going to do a single crochet in the second chain from our hook. So there's our first chain. We're going to go into the second chain here and we're going to do a single crochet. So you're going to push your hook in the chain, yarn over and pull up a loop. You now have two loops on your hook. You're going to yarn over and pull right through both. And that's a single crochet. All right. So you're just going to go ahead and work one single crochet in every single stitch all the way down the row and then come back. So go ahead, pause the video, work a single crochet in every chain and then come back. All right, so now that you have worked your single crochets all the way down the row, you're going to chain one and turn your work. Okay, so now we're going to work one single crochet in each of the first three stitches of this next row. So just regular single crochets, and we're going to do in the first three stitches, so that's two and three. Now we're going to work a front post double crochet around the post from the row before last. So not around this post, but around this one. And we're going to work a double crochet. So yarn over your hook. Instead of pushing your hook in here, we're going to go below it to the row before last. Push your hook through, around behind the post and out the other side. So we're bringing that post to the front. Front post double crochet. You're going to yarn over your hook and pull up a loop. Sorry guys. Sometimes when I'm going like slow motion like that, it happens. I'm sorry. So push your hook in behind the post, out the other side. Yarn over and pull up a loop. Yarn over, pull through the first two loops on your hook, yarn over, and pull through the last two loops on your hook. Okay, and that's a front post double crochet around the post from the row before last. So we're going to go ahead and do the same thing around this next post. So yarn over, push your hook in around behind the post and out the other side. Yarn over, pull up a loop. yarn over, pull through the first two loops, yarn over, and pull through the last two. It can be a little awkward because we're starting our projects. So you're gonna have all these, like, you don't have much to grip onto here. The little flap is moving in your way. It gets easier as you go, so don't feel discouraged, okay? So we're gonna do this 6 times. So that's 2 so far. That's 3. Four, five, and 6. Okay. Now we're going to do a single crochet in the next 3 stitches. So just a regular single crochet. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. And then you're going to go, hang on, let me see something here for 1 minute, please. 1, 2, 3. So now we're going to go down and work our front post double crochets in around the posts from the row before last, just like we did these ones, 6 times again. So you're just going to go ahead and continue this all the way down until you get to the end of the row where you're going to be working your front post double crochets. Okay, so you're going to finish this 6 of these, and then you're going to do 3 regular single crochets, 6 front post double crochets, 3 single crochets. Go all the way down to the end and then come back. All right, so now that you have made your way to the end of that row, you should have finished with your 3 single crochets, finishing the same way that you started this row. And now you're going to chain 1 and turn your work. And now, just so that you guys know, I want to make a point to mention, I have made, so this one I'm doing in a solid color. Just to be honest with you, it does make it easier for the tutorial. And for the gift I'm making for this, it just, you know what, I just really love the look of this particular yarn on its own. If you wanted to do one with alternating colors, there is, with the written pattern options, when you click the link in the description below, you will be redirected to my website where there is the written pattern. The written pattern gives you, for the solid, just 1 solid color, and it also gives you the pattern for 2 colors, just like when to switch and whatnot if you need that type of direction. If you're just comfortable going ahead and just working on it and alternating colors if you feel like it, that's awesome. The pattern, like the actual steps itself, is no different at all. I just find that a lot of people, when it comes to something where you're switching and it has to be at particular times and whatnot, some people feel comfortable following exact steps. So I just wanted to put that out there and let you guys know. And I won't be doing a video tutorial for the 2 colors, the alternating colors. I'm just doing this one for the solid, but the written does have both options. Okay. So the next step here, we are going to work 1 single crochet in every single stitch all the way down. And when you're getting to this part here where you have like a front and a back, you're only doing it like you're doing your front, your single crochets are going all the way across this little front section. So it's going into all of the single crochet stitches and the top of all of the front post double crochets. So you're going to leave this alone, okay? Don't go attaching them. It'll make sense later, but it will ruin the effect. So just make sure that you're just working along the top. Okay, so you're literally just going to go ahead and work 1 single crochet in every single stitch all the way down. And I'll just do this one to show you what I'm talking about. You see? So I'm only working along the top. I'm leaving this alone completely. All right, so you're just going to go ahead and work that all the way down, oops, and then come on back. Okay, so now that you finish that row of single crochets all the way down, you're going to chain 1 and turn your work. We're going to begin this next row with our single crochet in our first three stitches. And then this is where it gets a little bit tricky, a little complicated when you're first getting the hang of this cable stitch. But I promise it does get easier and it will get a much, you'll get much quicker. It'll be much easier to follow. Okay. So when you're looking at your work, we're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 front post double crochets from the row before last, right? Because last row was a bunch of single crochets. The row before last, we did these front post double crochets. So we're going to be working in these, okay? We are going to be working with front post treble crochets because we need that extra bit of height, okay? So we're going to yarn over our hook once, and then yarn over our hook again, so twice, okay? We are going to skip these first two, and we're going to work in the middle two. We're going to front post treble crochet. So it's the same way you did a front post double crochet, but it's three times, and I'll show you. So you're going to go ahead and work around that post, yarn over, and pull up a loop. You're going to yarn over, pull through the first two, yarn over, pull through the next two, yarn over, and pull through those very last two. Okay? And we're going to do that again in the one beside it. Okay, we're working our front post treble crochets. So we've got two in the middle two posts. Now it gets a little awkward, but just bear with me. Okay? So we're going to yarn over our hook twice. We're going to go and put our hook behind these two that we just made, and we're going to go down into that very, very first post and work. Oh my God, this is so awkward to try and show it on camera. Sorry, guys. Okay, so in behind those two and get your hook into that very first post, like around it. We're doing our front post treble and pull it up behind. Okay, we're working behind the two that we just did. And you're going to yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through the first two. It's going to look like a mess right now, but don't worry. Yarn over, pull through the next two, and yarn over and pull through the last two. Yarn over your hook twice for the next treble crochet. And go back behind those and around that. You got to find that second, the second post there that got skipped, and just put your hook around it and pull it up behind, okay? So you're looking at it while you're working here. Yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over, pull through the first two. Yarn over, pull through the next two. Yarn over and pull through the last two. So you can kind of see that a little bit of a crisscross effect happening there. And now we got to go ahead and work around these two little lonesome doves at the end here, because we've only worked around four of our posts so far. We've got six to work with. So yarn over twice, and we're going to work front post treble crochets around these last two posts. It is so awkward. You're probably second guessing yourself if you've never done this stitch before. Like, what am I getting myself into? I'm going to move on to another project. It's too awkward. I hate it. Stick it out, because you are going to be so glad that you did. It's gorgeous, and it gets a lot easier. It gets so much easier. You're going to be like, there's no way that this is going to be easier. Yes. Yes, it will. Don't worry. Hang in there. I'm going to do one more with you. And then if you're stuck, you're just going to have to rewind back and rewatch it. Otherwise, this video is going to be like incredibly long. Okay. So we are going to do a regular single crochet in the next three stitches. And three. And let's go ahead and just tackle this next batch together. So we're skipping our first two and we're working in our middle two. We are going to front post treble crochet, we're just going to be doing, like, this is the same all the way down this row, okay? So literally, if you're stuck, just wind back and watch it again. And front post treble crochet around that next one right beside it. So we've now worked a front post treble crochet around our two middle ones. So now we're going to work our annoying front post treble crochets by going in behind. So we're going to go behind these two. We're going to find that first one, wrap our hook around behind it, and pull it up behind the two that we just made. And yarn over and pull up a loop. Yarn over, pull through the first two loops, the next two loops, the last three loops. And we're going to do that again to that second post that got skipped. Okay? And I promise it's going to get so much easier. Maybe it already is for some of you guys who are like total champions. It took me a few rows before I got comfortable with this stitch. I was like completely cursing it and I hated it and I was so mad because I had to have it. I needed to learn this stitch because it's so gorgeous. I love it. Like, it is one of my most cozy hats. I have like a cable stitch messy bun hat. That pattern is available, by the way. And it's one of my absolute favorites. It's just absolutely gorgeous. And it's blue as well, actually. It's a few shades of blue. I didn't realize I liked blue so much, but I guess I do. Okay, so that's the second one. So now you're going to just continue that on. You got to do your three single crochets and then do that, your front post treble crochets. Three single crochets, front post treble crochets, three single crochets, and then come on back and I'll show you the next step. Okay, so now that you finished that row, you can see a little bit of crisscross action happening, but you still won't be seeing the cable effect yet. Don't worry, that's normal. So you're going to chain one and turn your work. And you're just going to go ahead and work your single crochets all the way down. Kind of like between every one of our cable rows, we're working single crochets. It's like our little reset row. And just don't forget that you're working along the top of those treble crochets. You're leaving this little back flap alone. So go ahead and work your single crochets all the way down and then come back. Okay, so now that you finished that row of single crochets, you are going to chain one and turn your work. It's very important that you remember to do that chain one and turn your work. That's going to be what you do for the end of every single row, okay? Just in case if I forget to mention that as we go, you got to do it for every row. Okay, so we're going to single crochet one time in our first three stitches. Okay, and now I want to mention something briefly because after this next row, I'm just going to let you go on your way until you get to the height that you need. So when you have worked this row, you saw the way that you did the first cable row. This next one is a little bit different. And then it's literally just alternating. So you would then repeat this one for the next, and then this one, all the way, okay? If you want the written pattern to go with it, there is a link in the description below, as I mentioned, where you can go ahead and get that. Okay, so when we did our first row of cables, that's just what I'm going to call it, the cables, okay? When we did our first row of cables, we skipped our first two and we worked in the middle two. That's where things are a little different, okay? So for this one, we are going to work, it's treble crochets all the way now for our cables, okay? So we're going to work front post treble crochets around the first two posts. So you're going to go ahead and work your, sorry, one second here. Front post treble crochets around the first two posts. That's one, and two. Now, we're going to skip these two and do our front post treble crochets around the last two. And this is what's going to be giving our, that like braided look. And you'll start to notice it. If you don't notice it too much after this, you'll notice it for sure after the next cable row you do. Okay, so now we have this. We are now going to work our last two in the middle. So you locate those two middle ones. Here's one, here's two. Okay, do you see that there? One and two. Okay, we're going to go over the two that we just did. Remember the first one we went in behind? So this is over. It's easier. This one's much easier. It's not so awkward. So you're going to go over and work around that first of the two middle. Front post, treble crochet. And when you're doing all this like pulling, going over, going behind, it's going to look like such a mess in your hand. Don't worry, because when you let go and you stretch it out, it looks beautiful. And we're going to work our last cable around that second one of the middle, our treble, front post, treble crochet. And then we're going to do our three single crochets. Sorry, I always get a little bit thrown off for a quick second there. One, two, and three. So let's have a little look. You see the way that's kind of starting to look there? You'll definitely see it after the next row or two, okay? So if you need to see how to do that again, just wind it back a little, but you're gonna go ahead and repeat this, what you just did, all the way down, and in between each one, of course, is your three single crochets, and you're going to finish with three single crochets. You're going to chain one and turn your work. You're going to do single crochets all the way down, chain one, turn your work, and then you'll be here at the start again. And here at the start again is where you're going to repeat the first cables, the first row of cable that we did. All right, and you're just going to alternate like this all the way for, let me see how many rows you got to do. So you're going to just keep on alternating this pattern, like doing this pattern with those alternating cable rows. Make sure you're doing a row of single crochet between each one, because that's what kind of gets you back to the start to reset, because you got to be having it facing all the same way. And you're going to keep working this for a total of 53 rows, okay? So you go ahead and keep on working that for a total of 53 rows. And I'm talking like legit 53 rows. Like you can count your 53 by counting your single crochets, okay? When I say 53 rows, I don't mean 53 like entire cable rows. I mean 53. So that includes each of the little cable stitch rows is its own row, and each single crochet row is its own row. So I would really advise keeping your count from the single crochet rows, okay? Otherwise, you're going to just confuse the hell out of yourself in here because your single crochet rows are hidden in behind and whatnot. So I don't know how you like to do that, if you want to use a stitch marker or what, but you're going to be doing a total of 53 rows, and then you're going to come on back. Okay, so now that you have finished 53 rows, isn't that looking so gorgeous, guys? Come on. Wasn't that worth it? Some of you are probably like, gosh, why does she keep on talking like it's such a headache? It was fine. It was nothing. But to me, when I was learning this stitch, I almost threw in the towel a couple times. It was really hard. So if some of you found that hard, don't feel bad. You're not alone. I freaking hated this stitch when I first did it. Okay, but it's so worth it. It's so beautiful. I'm so glad I stuck it out. Don't you feel so proud? Those of you that stuck it out, I'm proud of you. All right, so now we're going to chain one and turn our work. And we are going to begin to decrease a little bit here. We need to decrease a little bit here because no baby is going to be having like, you know, their little armpit area, chest area, shoulder area this wide. So let's go ahead.
Okay.
So now we are going to work a single crochet decrease. So we're going to take our hook and just push it in that first stitch, yarn over, and pull up a loop. Hold that loop in place and go right into the next stitch. Push your hook in, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, and pull right through all the loops on your hook. So for those of you that are not familiar with decrease stitches, what we've done is we've taken these two stitches and we've turned them into one, okay? And now we're going to single crochet times one in the next two stitches. So that's one and two. And then we're going to do another decrease. So push your hook in the stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. Push your hook in the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over, pull through all the loops. And you're going to single crochet in the next two stitches. So you're literally just going to go ahead and repeat that all the way down, doing one decrease, two single crochets, one decrease, two single crochets, all the way down, and then come back.
Okay, so now that you've finished row of decrease, you're going to chain one and turn your work. So now what we're going to do is moss stitch, and we're going to work our moss stitch for a total of 8 rows. And I'm going to show you how we're going to do that. So you're going to do a half double crochet in the first stitch. So you're going to yarn over your hook, push your hook into the stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. You've got 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through all 3. Okay, so that's a half double crochet. Now going into that next stitch, we're going to do a slip stitch. So you're going to push your hook through the stitch, yarn over, and pull right through both loops. And we're going to do a half double crochet in the next and a slip stitch in the next. And you're just going to go ahead and keep on working these alternating stitches all the way down till the end of the row. You're going to chain one and turn your work, and then come back and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so we're going to continue on the same way we just did that last row, but there is a little bit of a difference because when you're working into your next row of your moss stitch, you want to make sure that you're working all of your half double crochets into the slip stitches from the previous row and all of your slip stitches into the half double crochets of the previous row. So we ended our last row with a slip stitch. We're going to begin this one with a half double crochet. Okay, and that's really all there is to it, to a moss stitch. You're just making sure that you're working the stitches alternating like this and making sure that, like I said, your half double crochets go in the slip stitches and your slip stitches go in the half double crochets. So you're just going to go ahead and continue on with that, making sure to chain one before you turn your work at the end of each row. So work this for a total of 8 rows. That's including the one that you've just already completed. So you're doing 7 more right now and then come back. Okay, so now that you just finished those rows of moss stitch, you're going to just do your chain one and just pull a little bit of extra yarn out for a little tail in there, and you're going to fasten it off. Okay, just pull that the rest of the way through. We'll weave that in later. Don't mind these, it's because my yarn ran out, so I had to reattach it. So that's why those tail ends are there. You didn't miss any steps, don't worry about that. So now what we're going to do is in the third stitch from where we just fastened off, so 1, 2, 3, we're gonna reattach our yarn to make another little starting loop there. So you're just going to pull it right through and chain one. And then, so starting in that same stitch, you're going to work 4 stitches across, continuing on with your moss stitch. So I've attached this into what was a slip stitch. So I'm going to start with a half double crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And sorry, I said 4, but it's actually supposed to be 5. So just go in that one more stitch right there. My mistake. Okay, so it should be 5 stitches that you have just done across. So 1 in the same stitch where you attached the yarn, and then in the following 4 stitches, so 5 in total. Okay, then you're going to chain one and turn your work. And these are going to be the little shoulder straps. So you're just going to go ahead and work your way, still working your moss stitch, back down those same 5 stitches. And you're just going to continue doing that. Make sure that you chain one at the end and turn your work. And you're just going to continue doing that all the way until you reach the length of the strap that you want. So for me, here's the length of my strap, and I've worked it for a total of 9 rows. So you just go until the length that you want, and if you wanted to do it the same as mine that you see in that finished picture that you would have seen to come to this pattern, mine is for 9 rows. Okay, and when you finish that strap, you're just going to go ahead and pull a little bit up, fasten it off, and pull the rest of that through. And then you're just going to go over to the other side here and repeat the same thing. So going from the third stitch, 1, 2, 3, you're going to reattach your yarn in there. And you're just going to go ahead and repeat those very same steps that you just did for that first strap. Okay, so go ahead and just repeat those steps that you did for the first strap. Do that here and then come back. Okay, so now laying your work flat in front of you with the front of your work facing you, you're going to reattach your yarn at the bottom right corner. And you're going to chain 2. You're going to back post double crochet all the way down your work. So yarn over your hook, you're going to go and push your hook in the back of that stitch, around the front and through the other side. So you're pushing the post to the back. Yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through the first 2, yarn over, pull through the next 2. So you're just going to go ahead and do that all the way down the row. And when you get to the end, you're going to chain 2 and turn your work. Okay, so just go ahead and do that and then chain 2 and turn your work. Oh, what am I doing here? There we go. Okay, so go ahead, keep working your back post double crochets all the way down and then come back. Okay, so now that you got to the end of that row and you chain 2, you're gonna turn your work. Okay. Okay, so now we're gonna go down this next row, and what we're gonna be doing is front post double crochets. So you remember these from before, just gonna yarn over your hook, push your hook in around the back of the post to pull it to the front and back out the other side. Yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, go through the first 2, yarn over, go through the next 2. So you're just gonna go ahead and work your front loop double crochets all the way down and then come back. Okay, so after you finish working those front post double crochets, you're gonna chain 2 at the end and turn your work. You're gonna continue on with this alternating pattern. So when you turn your work, you're gonna go back to working your back post double crochets all the way down, chain 2, turn your work, front post double crochet all the way down. So you're gonna repeat those, this step that you just did, doing your back post double crochets, front post double crochets, you're gonna do that 2 more times. So you'll have a total of 6 rows by the end of the 2 more times that you're finishing this, okay? So you're gonna do back post double crochet, chain 2, turn your work, front post double crochet, chain 2, turn your work, and then repeat those 1 more time. And then you're going to come back here and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so now that you've finished those 6 rows, you are going to chain 1, turn your work, and we're just going to work 1 single crochet in every single stitch all the way down this row And when you get to the end, you're just going to fasten off and then come back. Okay, so now that you've finished the front of your baby sleep sack, we are going to put this to the side. And we are going to begin working on the back. So you're going to make your starting loop. Get your hook in there. And you're going to chain 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and just keep on going till you get to 40 and then come back. Okay, so now that you've made your chain 40, in the second chain from the hook, so there's the first, here's the second, we're going to do a half double crochet. And the next we're going to do a slip stitch. And half double crochet. And slip stitch. All right, so in case you haven't already guessed it, we are working a moss stitch. And we're going to work the moss stitch for the entire back of the baby sleep sack, almost the whole thing. So you're going to be working your moss stitch. Of course, you're going to, at the end of every row, chain one and turn your work. And when you're working your continuing rows, you'll be sure to work a slip stitch in every half double crochet from the previous row and a half double crochet in every slip stitch from the previous row. And you're going to go ahead and keep on working those rows until, I'm just going to show you here, when your work reaches, if you're measuring it from this line, okay, the entire cable stitch length, right up until the top of the cable stitch at the top of your work. So you want your rows of moss stitch to measure the same length as your cable stitches, so just these parts. Okay, then we'll work on the bottom together and we'll work on the top together. But you want it to match the length of your cable stitches. Okay, so go ahead and work your moss stitch rows until you have gotten the full length matching the front of your cable stitch. So that when you hold it up to each other, it's the same length. So go ahead and work that and then come back. Okay, guys, so I want to touch on something. So I know that you think that you're done the back part, but I am really, really sorry. I have to point something out. I did make a mistake. It's okay. You don't have to undo anything. So don't worry about that. You just have a few more rows to do. Because when I had left you guys and told you how to do the back part, I told you you're going to be measuring from just the cable stitch portion, and that's my mistake. I'm really terribly sorry about that. It's right from the very bottom edge all the way up to the top of the cable stitch portion. Okay, so you're going to be working that back right up until the top of the cable stitch portion, but from the very bottom edge. So you're going to have to go ahead and work a few more rows. I'm really sorry about that. Go ahead and just continue those few more rows and then come on back. Okay, so now that you have went and finished that, I'm really sorry again about that, you guys. You are going to chain one and turn your work. Now what we're going to do at the start of this next row, we're going to single crochet decrease. So you're going to push your hook in that first stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, hold that loop on and go into the very next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. Then you're going to yarn over and go through all the loops on your hook. So single crochet decrease. Then you're going to follow your regular moss stitch. So as you can see, this next one is a half double crochet, so I'll be doing a slip stitch. And we're going to do our regular moss stitch for just two stitches. And we're going to do another decrease, single crochet decrease. And then our regular moss stitch for two stitches. So you're just going to go ahead and do that all the way down, alternating between single crochet decrease, regular stitch, single crochet decrease, regular stitch. Do that all the way down the row and then come back. Okay, so now that you've gotten to the end of that decrease row, you're just gonna chain one and turn your work. So now working no more decreases, you're just going to be working your moss stitch in every single stitch all the way down, chain one and turn your work. You're going to do that for 7 rows and then come back. Okay, so now that you have finished those rows, you're going to chain one, and then what you want to do is just line up your work. Sorry, I literally just got the yarn wrapped around the camera there. Line up your work so that it is inside out. So the cable stitch on the inside. Okay. Line it up really good there. Obviously with the straps above the work. Sorry guys, it's not a very good view. That should be a little better. So you're going to want your work to line up right to this corner here, right? This is the top edge. So just at the corner where the strap begins is where you want the corner that you just left off on. You see that there? That's how you want to line it up. And then just get it lined up. You got to try and keep it as even as possible. And what you're going to do is take your hook. Now this is going to be a little awkward starting. You're just going to want to find that corner stitch and get your hook right in there. And just pull it through. Chain one is just always what I do to start it off. And you're literally just going to go down the edge and connect the two sides together with slip stitches. It's really awkward. You might even have to do like separate it and do one side at a time. And you're just going to connect it with slip stitches all the way down. Okay. You're going to do that all the way down. And now when you get to the bottom, it's really your choice what you want to do. I used to, with all the other sleep sack patterns you're going to see that I've done, I usually go all the way down across the bottom, back up the other side, and I just leave the top open. I did have some feedback from somebody on the last baby sleep sack I made, which was my owl sleep sack. And someone made a comment saying it'd be really nice if you just did some kind of closure that can open and close at the bottom, right? Because, I mean, really the whole idea of a sleep sack is that it's supposed to be a baby blanket. It's supposed to be larger than the baby, obviously, right? It's supposed to be a blanket that can't get kicked off. That's the whole point of it. So they're cozy all through the night. So in theory, their feet would not be at the bottom. So, because I always used to think to myself, well, I won't want to put a closure because it might be uncomfortable, but their feet don't even reach the bottom. So for this particular sleep sack, what I've done is a zipper. I leave the bottom open. So I'm just slip stitching down one side, fastening it off at the corner, slip stitching up the other side and fastening it off. And then I'm sewing a zipper to the bottom so that it can be open and closed for easy access for diaper changes without having to take off the entire sleep sack. It really was a great suggestion. So I went ahead and I took that to heart and I've applied that suggestion to this sleep sack. So when you go ahead and you finish doing down the sides and you're just going to fasten it off, you are going to use, and if you decide to do the bottom, close it, that's fine. Like I've said, I've done that in every other sleep sack I've made. You'll see them in my other patterns. Or you can do like what I'm doing for this particular one where I am sewing on a zipper and I'm just sewing it using a yarn needle and the matching thread. Nothing big and fancy about it there. And I'm using my yarn needle to hide all the tail ends. I'll show you how I'm hiding the tail ends. So I just literally thread my little yarn needle. And I just, on the inside of the work, obviously you want it to be like as if it's inside out. And I just go ahead and weave that in and out of some of the stitches. And this is literally like, when I say I sew the zipper, I'm literally just going through the material of the zipper with my yarn needle and my thread. And I sew it on, just attach it, secure it as best I can. I'm not a great sewer. So literally if I could figure that out like just go ahead and just attach it. Anybody can. You could do some buttons. I don't really like the idea of buttons or anything like that when I'm doing baby sleep stuff in case they do pull it off. You know, I get scared with choking hazards. But you could even do like a little drawstring. That would be cute too. I mean, come on, it would like literally look like a little bag. Anyway, there's a few different ideas there. If you wanted to go ahead and do the zippers and you don't have a fabric store near you, or you're in a situation where you can't be going out right now, and you just want to have it delivered to you, I've included a link in the description below to the Amazon link where I ordered my zippers. I got a whole bag full of them, all different colors. Fantastic. So anyway, yeah, there you go. That's you're literally just going to go ahead and do those two sides, the seams, and hide your tail ends, and your baby sleep sack is done. Mm-hmm.